Hey everybody, what's up? I hear on the news all the time how kids and seniors are dying from swine flu, and I never imagined that I would actually. I mean, you see the stories on the news, you see the long lines that people are waiting in to get their children vaccinated, to get their loved ones vaccinated. You see the long lines and you hear stories of people that have waited in line for hours only to be turned away and told that they're out of vaccinations. Today when I went to the gym, when I walked in and got ready to slide my card, there's a little box at the counter and I saw the little boy's picture on it and I just didn't pay attention to it. And I went and I did my workout, and on my way back out, the lady who signed me up for the gym and checks in on me and makes sure I'm okay and making sure I'm like getting what I need there at the Y was standing at the front desk. So I walked over and we started talking, and then I looked at the box again and I asked her what was the deal with the box, and she explained to me that a lady that works there, young lady that works there, who is lesbian, that is her little brother. I believe he was 13 years old, and that he had died from the swine flu. And my heart just sank, and I was like, wow, he died from the swine flu. My heart just literally sank. And when she told me that the donation box is there to help the family pay for the burial because they can't afford it, my heart sank again, because when you think about death, you're already dealing with so much. You're already dealing with the loss of a loved one. You're already going through your grieving process and the mourning and everything. And just to miss the person that is no longer with you. Imagine, if you will, in addition to all the feelings that you are dealing with and all the things that you are going through and comforting your loved ones and family members, that you also have the concern of not being able to bury the person that has passed away. Imagine this is a child, a 13-year-old boy, and my heart just went out to her, and I talked to Kelly a little while longer, and then I walked out, and I believe I told Kelly I will donate what I can. And I came home, and right when I got home, I got an alert from PayPal that somebody had put $50 in my PayPal. And then I got an email from a woman, I believe she's in Brooklyn, who wants to use three of my pictures that are on Flickr for a project that she's working on, and she didn't just want to take the pictures, so she actually paid me $50 to use the pictures, and asked if it was okay. And then she said, and even if it's not okay, she wanted me to keep the $50. And I told her it was fine, and I told her I really appreciated that she, one, asked, and then actually paid me for the photography. Not that I'm looking to get paid for my photography, but it was definitely a great gesture. It was very much appreciated. So right when I saw that, I was like, well, you know what, I can just use this $50 to give to the family to help them bury their child. I've never met the young lady who actually works there at the Y, whose little brother has died, but my heart goes out to you. I am so sorry for your loss. Please express my condolences to your family. Words can't describe what I'm feeling right now, so I know you must be feeling so much more. So I hope this $50 helps. And I just want to say to my YouTube viewers and to anybody else who sees this video, is during this season that we're supposed to be so thankful, there are so many people that don't have a lot to be thankful for. There are so many people who are losing their homes. There are so many people who are homeless on the streets. There are so many people battling HIV and AIDS with no medical, cancer, Alzheimer's, all kinds of things. There's people going through so much in this country. And it is so easy for any of us to just walk right by it and pretend like we don't see it happening, or pretend like we don't hear it happening, but then we'll send thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars to other countries where we don't even know how or where that money we sent will be spent, or if it'll actually make it to the person that it was intended for. And I would just challenge everybody that not just during the month of November, but all year, find it within your heart, find it within your soul, within the every fiber of your being, to reach out to somebody. Either do it once a month or once every other month, and you can get friends together and do it. And just really try to impact someone's life, and do it from the most purest place. Do it from a place where you're not expecting anything in return. And just watch how you can bring change that we all want in this world, peace that we all want in this world, by one simple act, and that is just simply loving people, showing love to people. Think, if you will, if it were your child or your little brother that has just died from swine flu, and you're coming into Thanksgiving, a time where you want to be with your family, and you now have to bury your little brother or your son, and you don't have money to do it. Think about that when you're out doing your shopping and you're buying your turkeys and your hams and whatnot to prepare for your holiday dinner. Think about families who are burying loved ones. Think about people in the military who are coming home dead. Their bodies are being sent home to their families. Think about that. Think about the thousands upon thousands upon thousands right here in LA. But the thousands upon thousands upon thousands upon thousands in the United States who go to sleep nightly with nothing to eat, with no warm clothing, no clean clothing. Think about those people and try to think about those people as being someone you love, someone you care for. Think about those persons as being you. Like I said, I know this $50 isn't much. It's what I could afford. And I just want to ask that everybody find it within their heart to move forward in love and do things in love, not just for the month of November, not just for the month of December, not just January, but all year long. It's not a Christian thing, it's not a Buddha thing, it's not a Jehovah thing, it's a human being thing. Be human, care for each other. That's what we were put here to do, to support each other. In good times and in bad times, white, black, pink, purple, gray, whatever. We're humans. We all hurt, we all bleed, we all have loss, and we all have struggles. Let's step out of judging and using the Bible to judge, or using the Quran or whatever it is to judge people, and let's just suit up and show up for humanity. Let's suit up and show up for our neighbors, for our brothers and sisters. Not for community, but for humanity. Again, Kelly, thank you for allowing me to do this. Thank you for sharing this information with me. And to the young lady that works at the Y, I hope this helps with the burial of your little brother. So I'm gonna take this over to the Y right now. Thanks, guys.